Good morning, students. Hope all are doing good. Today, I am going to tell you the summary of this story after 20 years. Let's begin it. It's a short story about two best friends, Jimmy Wells and Bob. They decide to go down different paths and make a pact to meet at the same place after 20 years. Bob leaves New York to go try his luck in the West, and Jimmy decides to stay and becomes a cop. The story opens with a cop walking around the deserted streets of New York in the evening, doing his duty and checking the locks of every establishment and business that he passes by. He finds a man standing in the doorway of a hardware store. The man has an unlit cigar in his hand. On inquiring, he tells the cop that he is waiting for an old friend who he had promised to meet at the very place 20 years ago before going west. He tells him that he is waiting for Jimmy Wells, his old friend with whom he had spent his childhood as a brother. While talking to him, the man lights his cigar, and in that brief illumination, the cop notices that the man has a pale face and a scar near his right eyebrow and sharp eyes. The man boasts that he has and wishes that his plodder friend has done at least half of what he has achieved. And he is sure that if his friend is alive, will definitely meet him. After a few minutes, a man arrives and introduces himself as Jimmy. Bob is happy to find his friend, and both men share their stories. Bob notices that Jimmy has changed. In fact, was taller than he remembered. Jimmy insists that since the old restaurant is not there anymore, they should go to some other place. As they pass the street light, Bob looks at his friend's face and says that though 20 years can change a man in many ways, it rarely changes the shape of a man's nose. The other man says that he is not the one whom you think, and Bob has been under arrest for the past 10 minutes. He tells him to come with him quietly and hands him a letter. A letter says, "I was at the place on time, Bob. I saw the face of the man wanted by Chicago police. I didn't want to arrest you myself, so I went and got another cop and sent him to do the job." Jimmy. The note was written by Jimmy. I hope all of you must have understood the story. Thank you.